I am Antonio Calanducci from the Istituto Nazionale of Fisica Nucleare in Catania, and I'm going to present you this work on digital libraries on the grid. So I guess that many of you have ever used this object here, the iPhone or maybe the iPod. To manage music, videos on the iPhone, on the iPod, use this piece of software from Apple, it's called Apple iTunes. So we have a question. Can we think the grid data storage as it was a huge iPod? So we need a way to organize our files on the grid. So GLibrary allows to store, organize, search, and retrieve digital assets on a grid environment. What we mean by digital assets? We mean photo, we mean music, videos, emails, presentations, invoices, logo, and why not? Even ancient manuscript. GLibrary allows to organize your assets by type and by category. Each administrator of a library defines the types that he wants to manage on the digital library he's creating and defines a type tree. Then we have the browsing system that is modeled on the iTunes software. Instead of handling here music or videos, we can handle anything can be stored in the system. So here we have a use case. It's the manuscripts, typescripts, draft of a famous Italian writer, Federico De Roberto. And this work has been done in collaboration with the Faculty of Letters and Philosophy in Catania. They have digitalized more or less 8,000 documents, producing more or less 3 terabytes of this space. We used the iTunes for the Grid, the GLibrary, to access the people these documents. So here you see some screenshot of the interface. You have on the left the type tree, so you can select, for example, manuscripts, typescripts, printed text, and then on the other side you can choose one or more filter that's allowed to narrow the rest of set. And here you can expect many of the metadata available. And clicking on one of the items on the list, you get the possibility to edit some of the metadata. And going to the download tab of this interface, you have a list of choice from where you can download the files. And here you get the result just in your browser. So anyone with a browser and with a grid proxy, with a grid certificate, can download and view these documents.